Hey, you're watching with Wendy, and today I'm going to show you three things. One, how to cut your jeans to turn them into shorts. Two, how to add in rips and distress your jeans. And three, how to add lace trim to the bottom of your jeans. All this is going to give you today's tutorial, lace jean cutoffs. This DIY is super easy and it's perfect for festival season. All you'll need for this tutorial is lace trim, a pair of jeans that you want to shorten, and an X-Acto knife or utility knife, whichever one you call it. If you keep watching till the end, you'll also see how I got these 2-week tattoos on my hands. I put them on to get into the music festival theme, so I thought it'd be helpful to you as well. Let's get started. These are a pair of Bermuda denim shorts that I picked up from the thrift store. They're not the most flattering length, but they were white, which is what I was going for so that I could match the lace. I flipped them over, checked them out. The pockets are pretty standard and it had this brown leather accent on the back, which I kind of liked. Now, when it comes to turning these jeans into cutoffs, some people make a big mistake. You think you can just lay the jean flat, cut straight across, but that is actually going to end up being a very bad fit. You're gonna lose all the fabric that you needed to cover your butt cheeks, so I'm gonna show you how to do it properly. The way you need to do it is you need to focus on the X, which is the place in the crotch where the front, back, and two sides meet. This is the point that needs to be laying totally flat when you're cutting your jeans across, so that you leave enough fabric on the backside to cover your butt properly. I also recommend flipping the jeans over so that you're looking at it from the back and pulling on the pockets on the inside to make sure that they're totally out of the way. The reason you want to do it from the back is because we're going to be cutting a slope from the inner leg all the way up the side, and you don't want this to accidentally cut through the back butt pocket. I wanted my jeans to be about 1 inch long, so I started at the 1 inch mark on the crotch and then cut a straight slope all the way up the side, but making sure that I didn't touch the inner pocket and also the outer pocket. Flip down the inner pocket just to make sure everything is looking okay, and now we're gonna repeat this on the other side. Again, making sure you've pinched the fabric completely at the crotch, we're gonna be focusing on the other side. I lay it out flat, and then I like to take the scrap of fabric that I had cut off from the other leg and lay that on top. This is how I make sure I cut my two legs to be the same. I also like to flip the shorts onto the side to double check if everything is rounded up nicely on those sides. Typically, I'll go in and cut a little bit of a slit to help round out where the front meets the back, and then also go in to cut off a little bit of that seam fabric so that it's not showing. And now you've turned your jeans into cutoffs. Congratulations! The next step is going to be adding the lace. There's a certain type of lace that seems to look good with these jeans. They should have a deep, jagged edge, even better if it can have a little bit of eyelash action on the sides. I found this lace at a local store downtown and bought enough to encircle both legs of the shorts. The lace is gonna have to start and stop at some point, and usually I'd like to put that where not a lot of people look, so I start and stop the lace at the inner leg. I pin my way all the way around both of the legs and then snip off any excess when I get to the other end. Once everything was pinned up, I took it to the sewing machine and used a very small zigzag stitch all the way across the lace to secure it to the jeans. I showed you how to turn your jeans into cutoffs, add a lace trim, and lastly, we're gonna go through how to distress your jeans. The most common place to distress is the hips. I slid in a folded piece of paper directly underneath the piece of fabric that I was working with, then went in with my X-Acto or utility knife and did a couple of quick strokes outward. Your goal is not to literally cut straight through the fabric, but instead to start wearing down the threads so that they're not as strong and connected as they used to be. As you keep going, you'll start to notice spots where the fabric is starting to thin out and lose its structural integrity. Keep going at those spots, and eventually you'll be able to find a small slit that you can rip wide open now that you've weakened the fabric. Here's my first spot. I pulled it open with my fingers and ripped it along the sides until it was the width of rip that I wanted. With the X-Acto knife, focus on the area that's about a half inch above that rip. We're going to be putting in a second rip in that spot, so we need the fabric to be weaker. Now that you have two rips, go ahead and start pulling out the long threads from both sides, making sure that you're not breaking any of these threads, but just gently pulling them out. After a while, if it gets a bit tricky, start focusing on those vertical little threads and just keep tugging on the whole thing overall until the little threads and the long threads all come out. It takes a little bit of cleanup to get rid of the little threads, but what you'll be left with is the horizontal threads, which will give you the distressed look. I repeated this on both hips of the shorts, adding as many rips as I wanted until it was distressed enough for me. Whenever you're trying to create these ripped sections, keep focusing on distressing a half inch width at a time, and that will help make sure that you can work with all the threads. Thanks for making it to the end of the video. If you like this video, let me know. If you'd like to see more pictures of these shorts, I will be putting a few up on my Instagram. You can look it up under @withwendy. About my hand tattoos, the company is called Inkbox. I met the owners about a year ago. The two of them started this company with a realistic black ink tattoo. Essentially, you go on the website, pick your stencils, let the ink set into your skin using the stencils, and then kind of like henna, after you're done the whole procedure, the ink fades into its full darkness. After that, it lasts about 2 weeks. I have a wedding to go to this Saturday, so I'm gonna have these on my hands. If you haven't seen vlogs from my Europe trip last year, my friend Natalie and I played with these tattoos for the entire trip. We put on new tattoos every city we went, and it was really fun. I'll put a link down below for the tattoos, for the Europe vlogs, and also for the fringe jacket that I made that's also in this music festival theme. Finally, if you haven't subscribed yet, click the button below. I upload new videos every Wednesday, every Saturday, just like this one. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.